Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel, Mississippi Girl Gardening and Savings in NC. I am Tamika coming at you with not an oldie but a goodie video. So y'all, in this video, we're going to do a garden tour. So I am kind of late on this because I was supposed to do this, Tuesday, Wednesday, and today is Saturday. So I'm kind of late, y'all. I've been busy, but better late than never, okay? So I'm going to show you guys some of the things that I pulled up and got rid of in the garden. Some of the things that I added to the garden and everything. So I want y'all to sit back, relax, and enjoy this video, y'all. Alright, y'all. So I'm going to walk on up over here. And y'all see a difference? Yes. I got rid of all the cabbage and the stuff. It was bringing too many pests. I just think here in my area, it's just, I'm going to master it, okay? So, remember I had it all up here. So, supposed to be having somebody come and they're supposed to be redoing this fence. So, I'm going to end up pulling everything from the fence anyway. So, that's why I didn't put these buckets back. But these are some new plant babies. Some new plant babies that I got going on. This is all my stuff that was from seed that I had to transplant. So, we got black beauty eggplant right there. This is a green night eggplant. Black beauty right here. This is a white night eggplant. So I have the green and the white night eggplant, and this is a white night, okay? And then over here in these buckets, I have white night, green night, and green night, okay? So those are my eggplants, all right? So right here is my marigold. So this is one of my back to the roots grow bags that I had been had, y'all, that I bought like 2 months ago or something like that. So these are my African marigolds. Y'all already know all these plants were pretty much goners at Lowe's, and so they was on discount. They was pretty much done, and they doing good. Especially the salvia is doing good. My petunias right here is doing good, and my Dusty Millers. Y'all know I like Dusty Millers. And then these are my African marigolds that I started from seed. They are doing so good. I use this for the greenery for my little flower arrangements. And then recently I added some Dusty Millers down here in there, so they doing really, really good. So let's go right here. So I just transplanted these today, so they are droopy because less than 2 hours ago I did transplant these. These are going to be some zucchini grillers. So I got two in that pot because they're not supposed to be as big as the regular zucchini plants. So I put two in the pot in the buckets, and we're going to see what they do. But they droopy, like I said, because I transplanted them today. They will perk up. Right here is my scallop, my white scallop squash, my lemon squash. I ain't got no little thing in here to say what you are. I used to do. This is my acorn cream of the crop squash. Another acorn cream of the crop. Right here. I don't know why my thing's over there. This is a crookneck squash. I don't think. Remember I had two that just did not want to do right. I'm probably going to take him up because I ain't got time. Because he been slow. Right over here, y'all, is, I think this is crookneck. It's either crookneck or straight neck. It's one of them. But it's squash. Look, y'all. Can y'all see? Look, y'all. Look at the little squashies. Yay. So this is more squash. Crookneck squash. They are growing so crazy. Let me get that off up in there. And get it down here. Squash everywhere, y'all. And this is how they growing out of the buckets, y'all. Out of the buckets. And I do like the trellises because last year they was wild. But doing it this way, they are, you know, it's helping them a lot. Giving them a little bit more stability and stuff because these things grow really, really wild. Right here, I already can tell this is zucchini. Can y'all see the zucchini? Look. Can y'all see the zucchini? We got zucchini. Okay. All of these is between squash and zucchini, okay? Squash and zucchini. Got the little squashed over there. Yes. Y'all see how many it is? It's a lot of them. Look, y'all. They all up in there. So that's what all these are. Okay. Oh, wait. He's gonna be ready to come. Look, y'all. What? Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. I didn't see that. I came out here and was cleaning out everything. I didn't see that. He got big. Okay. So that's what all these are. So right here is my Ichabong eggplant. That's what they're gonna be. They're gonna be them purple long eggplant. And that's what this are too. Let's go right here. Right here is my Mad Hatter pepper plant that I recently got. And then this is an orange bell. This is my green frying pepper. Green frying pepper. These right here are spaghetti squashes. I started those from seeds. These two right here are red bell peppers. And I'm not going to go completely down the rows, y'all. But these are all green bell pepper, red bell pepper, orange bell peppers, sweet peppers, jalapenos. We got the culapenos. All different type, yellow bells. This right here, y'all, is a tomato plant. I'm gonna tell you, this looking droopy right now, but I broke it when I was getting these together. I'm gonna go over there and show you. I was getting these together today, putting some of my little plant clips and stuff on it to help them, because it was all wild. And one of the ends broke off. Y'all know I'm notorious with a tomato plant. When it break off, I just stick it in some soil. So that's gonna be a whole nother plant, okay? So the end, y'all know how it is. It looks droopy now, but it's because it broke off of one of these plants. And I stuck it in soil and gave it a plant marker. And yes, so look, y'all. The tomatoes. Look, he's big, y'all. He's big. We got tomatoes all up and down there. So these are the, I think these are the better boys or the big boy. Because I got so many different type of tomatoes, y'all. So many different type of tomato plants. Yes. So this is one I had to prop up. Now it wanna lean. I had to prop it up. But this is the one that one, I think it was this one, that it broke off from. So I just went on and potted it up so I can get me another plant out of it. But let me show y'all this. So this right here is the Midnight Snack. And I don't want to step in that ant pile. Look, y'all, this is how that tomato is gonna look. Y'all see that? They're like the little black ones. And this is the Midnight Snack, and they everywhere, y'all. So like I said, all type of peppers, jalapenos, red cayennes, poblano, all type of big boy tomatoes, better boy tomatoes, cherry tomatoes, Midnight Snack. The black cherry tomato is over there. All those is over there. So now let's go over here to this side. So let me show you my second Back to the Roots grow bag. Dusty Miller's got some pansies. Had got tulips in here, but y'all know tulips come back every year. So pansies, Dusty Miller's is what's in here. So now we're going to go over to this side. These are my nasturtiums and my begonias over here in my third Back to the Roots grow bag. Well, raised beds. These are my begonias in there. Ain't they so pretty, y'all? Can y'all see? They so pretty. Then we got some begonias right here. And like I say, these were rescued flowers, I'm going to say, because they was all dead and pretty much gone. We got some colas, some snapdragons, some Dustin Millers. Snapdragon's so pretty. And over here, I had started some more African marigolds. So that's what this greenery is. Some nasturtiums. Oh, they are leaking over from this one. And my pink snapdragons, okay? So, y'all, look. Carrots is doing really, really good. Really, really good. Let's see. I'm going to do something real quick. Because, y'all, summer eats out the summer. When we, she'll eat, like, the, let me see if it's going, I want one that's going. I want to see what it looked like. Okay. So, these are the, stuck it back in there. Which one of these? These are the shiny. So, I'm waiting. I was trying to see how big it was. If I had one that was big that I could give to Summer for a treat. Y'all, she had her popsicle a while ago. Summer had her popsicle with us a while ago. So right here, y'all, is the red ghost pepper, okay? So it is growing really, really good. Those are, like I said, are the carrots. Right here are the purple, the turnip purple top white globes. Right here is my kohlrabi. Right here is my radishes. Right here is what, let me see, Miss Kylie did, the bean, the golden wax beans. And they started off slow, but now they're getting it. And here are the Cherokee wax. This is what Little Aronde did. And they are going crazy, y'all. Right here is the tricolor wax beans that Tatiana did. And these are some lima beans. So if y'all can see, my beans has went crazy, y'all. They have went crazy, okay? They have went so crazy. So right here is my beets. I think it's about time for me to get my beets up. Right here is the sweet potatoes. They never came up. I did find one that looked like he was done, and then there's a tuber in there that's actually just started growing. So I'm gonna be adding more potatoes to that and filling it up with dirt. These right here, I think it's gonna be about time for me to start getting them because they done start kind of dying back. These are the colorful potatoes, and these are the iced potatoes. You see how they're dying back? So I'm gonna go ahead and I gotta harvest them. And these are some onions. The Texas sweet onions. So that's how everything right there look, y'all. I was so excited because over here we got a sugar snap. We got some sugar snaps. I said but I know we got more than one. We got a little one right there, a little one, see if you can see right there, and then we got that one. So they are coming, y'all. The sugar snaps are coming, and I really, really love sugar snaps. Peas. And right here is the smoking egg Carolina Reaper. Yes, yes. Over here is what hubby got his peppers. And over here, what he doing himself. Let me tell y'all, he planted them and I be watering them and fertilizing them, okay? But he say he doing it, okay? So he got purple bell, which I got that over there too. He got jalapenos, hot cayenne, poblano, sweet banana, which I got sweet banana over there. And mine's, he got the Carolina Reaper, and this is his ghost pepper right here. So that's his area. Now I'm gonna take y'all over here across to this one that's by that. And this is most of the stuff I did from seeds. These are poblano peppers over here, poblano peppers. This is the mammoth jalapeno. And this is my Cherokee purple tomato. Like I said, it's different types over there. Right here, let's go right here. Right here is my okra. That's my green okra, which is the Clemson spineless. This is my red burgundy okra. Some more Clemson spineless. And these right here are all sweet corn. These are sweet gold and white sweet corns. All right. And then right here is my orange bell. My green fire. I have another green fire sweet pepper. Right here is my tomato yellow pear. And I said my tomato yellow pear. And then over here, y'all, it's cucumber land. So I got the cucumbers here, and I told y'all I was doing them in buckets too, because that's what I did last year. That way y'all can see that they will grow and produce a lot in buckets. And then I have my raised bed with all the cucamelons. They are growing. I gotta get some trellises up for them. But I got my cucamelons, my pocetta cucumbers, the telegraph cucumbers, the white wonder cucumbers, the lemon cucumbers, the straight eight cucumbers, and the regular cucumbers all back there. So they are doing really, really good. Look, y'all, cucumbers is trying to come out the side. So right here we got, these I started from seed, is my super sweet tomatoes. Super sweet tomatoes, my orange bell, and my another green fryer. Okay. So let's go back over here. So right here is my colas, and they are doing good. They're coming along just good. And then right here is a bulb that we did. It's the Latrice mix or something like that. But hopefully it'll go ahead and flower soon, okay? But it's growing like crazy. I like how that looks. Right here is some more colas. And they are doing a thing. Yes. These are some flowers that the kids did. So Tatiana did this one. Ronde did this one. And Kylie did this one, which hers is starting to flower. That looks so weird, y'all. It's something red. We're going to see what it is, okay, when it comes. Now, I did get some trellises. The last couple of days, we done had a little bit of coldness. We weren't supposed to have no more coldness, y'all. But we had some. So, kind of watching everything. I don't want it to stunt nothing. But this is my blackberry bush. So, this is the one I bought this year. This is one I had from last year. And as you can see, the one from last year has a lot of berries coming. Okay, so I put the two red trellises on that one, on those. Right here is my gourd that I recently got. So they're doing really, really good. They're put on a lot of new growth. Right here, this is the blueberry bush that I had from last year. And this is the one I bought this year. So lots of blueberries. Lots of blueberries. Yay. Over here, I had to put some tomatoes over here, y'all, because I ran out of space. So over here is honeycomb tomatoes. These are my watermelons, Cherokee purple tomatoes, Cherokee purple, and I started all these from seeds. This is more Cherokee purple. Let me say this, y'all. I appreciate advice because I don't know it all. But I do my garden a certain way, okay? And I be getting comments, you know, y'all do your advice and everything like that. But please understand, people do their gardening the way they do it, okay? And let me tell you something about my trees. I am aware of some trees you need two of them, you know, to help them pollinate and stuff. But sometimes the trees that you don't need, just because you buy them, don't mean they're going to give you fruit that year or the next year. That don't mean that. So this is my pear tree. So I had, you know, someone and a couple of you guys that said I needed another tree. That may be so, but I want to see what this is going to do. When I got it, it was a stick. Now it got a whole lot of leaves on it. Okay, this is my pear tree. Please read your trees, because depending on the type of tree you have, it'll tell you if it needs another pollinator. My trees, I specifically picked the ones that don't, okay? Even my plum tree, it said it is self-pollinating. I don't need another one. Now, would it be beneficial? It may speed up the process and everything like that. Also, I do not own my home, and I have said this a couple times. We rent our home. I want to make it as easy as possible that when we do decide to move or buy or whatever the case may be, I can move my stuff. I'm investing in my garden, y'all, and I don't want to have to leave it behind. So I use 5-gallon buckets because that's easier. I'm thinking all different type of things, movement and everything. So that is why I use 5-gallon buckets. I could use something bigger like that. But I know this is a tree. I'd rather use a 5-gallon bucket till I get somewhere more, you know, where, like if I would go and buy a home, we get to that status. So that is why I do what I do. You have to do what you do and what's best for you, okay? So with that being said, that's my kumquat. I think I'm going to cut back. That's my tangerine. My Meyer lemon. It was doing something funky, y'all. It was dropping leaves, now it's putting leaves back on. And I'm going to continue to do what I've been doing. Let her do what she do. Simple as that. Right here, so this is something new. Well, new to the garden, y'all. So, I decided to bring these big 17-gallon containers that you can get from Walmart for $4.96. And this is what my melons is in. So we had that cold snap, and I told you guys, and this is what it left my melons. We got down to like 45 degrees here for like 2 nights straight. Yes, this was just day 4 yesterday. So I'm gonna end up taking all the droopy off, and you can see some of it is perking back up. But these are my cantaloupe, and they're gonna be just fine. My watermelon was droopy, and it bounced back up, okay? It bounced back up. Also, these mango watermelons, I did these from seeds. They was droopy. They bounced back, okay? Right here is my seedless grape. I bought it as a stick, and it still is a stick. So we're going to wait and see what it do. My muscadine, remember I bought it, it wasn't nothing but sticks. And look, we got so much fruit. Yes, I can't wait, y'all. I can't wait. I can't wait. So yeah. And then I saw this today. My raspberry bush is putting on fruit. Yes, y'all. Yes, so super excited. So that's how the garden looks now. So now we're going to go over here to the flowers. Remember the flowers? Hold on, y'all. I heard something in that grass. Summer! Yeah, girl, I was going over here, y'all, and this like the back of the fence line. I told you they supposed to be coming redoing this whole fence. And as I was walking, I heard something like it was creeping. Summer! Come here, Summer. Y'all hear that? I don't know what it is. Or maybe it's that little bird over there. I know I kept hearing, so I see a little bird right there. Come here, Summer. Come here. She in there, her lazy butt. She should be out here helping me. Come here. Go see what's over there. Go see what's over there. Good girl. Y'all have to call her because some sense her. She sensed something. Good job, Summer. You going to stay out here? Summer. So, y'all, this is my one of the flowers beds. So, they are looking really, really good. Like I said, these are the flowers that y'all saw that was dead. Yeah, it's a little bird, y'all. Little bird. That was really, really dead. And look what they doing. Ain't that so pretty, y'all? Oh, my goodness. Just to come out here and see that is so pretty. So these was all rescue flowers. They was clearanced out. They was pretty much dead. I cleaned them up, got them all in here, fertilized them, and that's what they doing. So this is the little flower garden, y'all. So now that y'all done saw everything and how it looks now and what I took up and everything like that, now we're going to go to the top of my deck and I'll be able to show you guys what's going on up there. But first, y'all, let me show you. So this, y'all saw this yesterday. This was the fourth back to the roots raised bed that I got. And I got everything in it. So we just still waiting, y'all, because that was just planted yesterday, okay? But I got it on the bottom part of the deck until everything, because I got more updates for y'all with this. All right, y'all. So this is what I have left that needs to be transplanted up here. It is peppers, pretty much. It's peppers and some more ground cherries, okay? And then right here is my sweet mint. Y'all saw me harvest that, so yeah, it's growing back like crazy. And then right here on the other side of the door is my chocolate mint, and it is going like crazy, y'all. So y'all, this is how my top deck look now. This is how it all looks. So we're going to start right here on this side. So my lettuce went on and bolted, but I got like three harvests of lettuce. So I got to put something else in these two pots. These are my Georgia collards that I had transplanted from that over there. And they are doing good. Right here, look, y'all. It is growing so much, so much. This is my purple top turnip root. It is growing like crazy. Right here is some Swiss chards. And then this is Swiss chard too. Right there is colorful Swiss chards. We harvested. Right here is some purple kale. We harvested. Right here is my mustard southern. I had thinned these out. So these are my mustard southern giant curled. And they are growing like crazy. Look, y'all. 5-gallon bucket. You know, I had somebody to tell me, oh, that's too many up in there. Y'all, look. See? This is what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. It's growing. Okay, it's a lot of space in a 5-gallon bucket. You know, it may not look like that, but it's a lot. So you got to know what you're growing to know what the root system is. So Right here is my Georgia collards that I transplanted. I'm going to be harvesting some of these bad boys. You know, I got 3 plants on a 5-gallon bucket, and they doing just fine. I got to thin those out. Those are more Georgia collards. I got to thin them out, y'all. I'm going to have more collard greens. And these are my Swiss chards over there. These are some more Georgian collards because I've been thinning them out, y'all. But I still got all those to thin. Oh, right here is my Georgia, some more Georgia collards. This is some Swiss chard. Y'all remember I cleaned this out. I still ain't put nothing in it. But what's left, what is in it is, look, y'all remember that basil I was online and I cut the top off from it? And then somebody said, why don't you just use that and make some more plants? And that's what I did. And look, it's growing back, y'all. Off in that one right there. Yep. So this is my dinosaur kale. I got to harvest it. Or you may know it as the La Cinco kale. And then I have red lettuce back there and red lettuce right there in that one. So right here is the patio tomatoes. So many tomatoes, y'all. So many tomatoes. So, yep. Then right here is some more Georgia collards that I transplanted. Right here is my peach tree. Get up, come on in there. My peach tree, and the peaches are getting bigger. Y'all see them? Peaches are getting bigger. And then right here, I put the little lights hanging on. I think it's cute. These are my ground cherries, y'all, that started from seed, okay? And they are growing. We getting flowers. So you know what that means. Some fruit gonna be coming, y'all. So these are my ground cherries. This is my pineapple mint. That's my my lily. My lily plant. Look, y'all. Strawberries. Strawberries. It is pretty. It is pretty. I got strawberries. Strawberries. So all these are strawberry plants. And y'all know I bought the fig tree up here because them little squirrels was at my figs. Look, y'all. Since it's been up here, it's been loving it. Oh, I'm gonna see if y'all can see them. Look at all them figs. Look at that, y'all. Woo, look at that. Figs, figs everywhere. It's loving it being up here on this deck, y'all. It's doing more than what it did last year, which, I mean, that normally happens. But at the same time, it's loving it up there, okay? It's loving it up here. So that's how my top deck looks. So when you walk out, this is what I see. I have my little umbrella, my little table. And then, you know, so I didn't show y'all up here. So up here was a bulb. It's like the one that I did down there. That's a smaller one. I love this little flower. These are my little rose bushes, like the ones I got in the front. This is my Sunny Meadows wildflowers I started from seed. I went on and cleaned up my daffodils because I know they'll come back next year. They did their thing. They was pretty. This is some garden sage. This is red and white, the lilac flower. It's going to be like this one, but it's going to be red and white. This is my lavender plant. Go back over here. And then I did all these from seeds. My Zilly Poop double mix. Some zinnias. My daffodil. Daffodils. I cleaned that pot out because I know they'll come back. My hyacinth, I cut that off. This is one that I picked up the other day. It was cute. It was a clearance plant. And then I have this one. So, yeah, you guys. So, that is what the garden is looking like, y'all. Okay, you guys. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video as much as I did filming it. I want you guys to get out there and be motivated and grow. It has so many benefits, y'all. And it's so much fun. It helps mentally. It helps physically. Everything. So I hope you guys get out there, grow your food, enjoy your garden, do your garden your way. Garden your way. Do what you want in your garden. You know, you gotta like your garden. You gotta be happy with your garden, y'all. So with that being said, you guys, I hope you guys enjoy. And I'll see y'all in the next video. If it's God's will, y'all be safe. And until next time, y'all, bye. Happy gardening.